What's up, everybody? You got Tommy the Hammer here hanging out with his good buddy, Adam McDougley's.
How's it going, everybody?
On a motherfucking Saturday night, and we're going to be checking out a new horror movie. Adam, tell my audience what we're going to be watching today.
Tonight, we're going to be watching a chiller called The House That Drip Blood.
Fuck yeah, man. I've been wanting to watch this for quite some time. Never actually seen this movie, but apparently Adam has watched it before. Adam, what's this movie about?
Well, basically, it's kind of like a 70s omnibus film, and omnibus just refers to a kind of film that has like numerous stories in it. They used to be quite popular back in the day. They don't really make them much anymore, which is unfortunate because they were pretty cool for what they were.
I love Peter Cushing. I love Christopher Lee. So we're going to be peeping the movie. I'm going to cut away to the trailer.
This house is full of sounds. The loudest is your heart pounding in the night. The softest is the sound of terror. In this house, terror waits for you in every room.
Where are they?
Vixens and victims. You'll find them all in The House That Dripped Blood.
In my opinion, I thought this was a very fun movie. I love anthology horror films. I thought Peter Cushing and Christopher Lee were both...
Never go wrong with them.
Yeah, I mean, they were both excellent. The production value is really good. And one thing I noticed about this movie and the stories is that the director really took his time with each tale. Nothing feels rushed. And if I did have any complaints to make, it would be that, maybe he could have trimmed the fat a little bit on the story. He's kind of got to the point. But overall, I was pleased with each story, and each one had something different to offer to the audience. So if you didn't like one, you might like the next.
It's got some great twist endings in here and all that. And I like the fact that each one deals with, like, different themes. Like, you've got the murder mystery, the supernatural, it's got kind of a vampire element to it.
A voodoo doll one.
Yeah, and it's like all the type of stories that were especially during this period, were really in vogue. And all
yeah.
That. And it just has kind of a very dark gothic English, feel to it and all.
Very moody, very murky with its imagery.
Yeah, very elaborate.
No complaints from me on this one. And if you guys are fans of Christopher Lee, if you like Peter Cushing, and you love that old, Hammer horror vibe of the 60s and 70s, then I can highly recommend The House That Dripped Blood. Out of 10 stars, I think I'd give this one, I'm going to go with like a 6.5, personally speaking. How about you, Adam?
Yeah, I'd give it the same, about a 6.5. A good, satisfying, entertaining, picture, and I think, but it's a step above it's a step above average, I think it's very entertaining. I think it's definitely one of the best, omnibus, films, especially from this period. I will say also that the house they used, the house that actually, that drew blood, where this all the stories take place, it's a really cool location.
Yeah.
I don't know where they scouted this place out. It was obviously a real house at one point, but
right.
It's great. I mean, it's like this old brick structure out in the English countryside.
I feel like the house itself was more omnipresent than the tales of terror. So, the set piece itself actually kind of evoked an emotion.
Yeah, that's why I think it was effective in that.
Yeah. So there you have it, guys. If you've never seen A House That Dripped Blood, we both highly recommend it.
If you're into this sort of thing, yeah you'll dig it.
Perfect for those dark and stormy nights. Check it out.